You're going to want to tune into the show this week when we show you a different way to make chicken and spaghetti. Stay tuned. Hi, I'm Rhonda Fitterer.
And I'm Laverne Didi.
And you found a recipe, Mom, this week that is a chicken spaghetti.
Yes.
So for those people that want a little bit different twist on just regular spaghetti, you're going to want to copy this recipe down because it looks really good.
It is. It's very good.
And we're going to have a no-bake dessert after that, which is always good coming up with, we're coming upon summer and people don't want to heat up the ovens.
Yep, absolutely. But it's good anytime.
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll take any time. That's right.
Yeah.
If you want to go ahead and cook along with us today, just grab a piece of paper and a pen and write down these ingredients for the chicken spaghetti. What you're going to need to make this dish is 8 ounces of spaghetti. You're going to need 2 cups of grape tomatoes, 2 jalapeno peppers, 4 cloves of garlic, 1/2 of yellow onion, couple tablespoons of butter, flour, and 2 cups of whole milk, or I would think 2% will work too, right?
Any of it will work, yes.
And 2 cups of cheese, of cheddar, and 2 cups of Monterey Jack. So we're getting a lot of cheese in here.
It's got a nice cheesy sauce to it, yes.
And then just a couple of spices. You're going to need 1/2 teaspoon of ground cumin, 1 teaspoon of cayenne pepper, 1/2 cup of chopped fresh cilantro, and two teaspoons, of lime juice, some salt and pepper, and then, of course, we need chicken.
And cooked chicken, that's right.
So that's a lot of ingredients, but it's not a hard ingredient. It's just
correct.
We're cooking.
It's easy. And this spaghetti is a white sauce. It's not, you know, the
traditional red sauce.
Spaghetti sauce and stuff. So first what I did, you know.
Well, let me read the ingredients. We need to get
the dessert.
How can you forget about the dessert, Mom?
I don't know.
Obviously, we're going to start with, you know, the spaghetti today, but
I'm excited about the spaghetti.
I know you are. If you want to do these no-bake chocolate peanut butter bars. Chocolate and peanut butter, fabulous together. You're going to need two cups of peanut butter, 3/4 cup, that's 1.5 sticks of butter, 2 cups powdered sugar, 3 cups of graham crackers, crumbs, and then 2 cups of chocolate chips.
That's right. Not a lot of ingredients, but very good.
All right.
So.
All right. So I know you want to get started on spaghetti, so let's, what do we got here?
Well, what I have here, you know, it's asked for the jalapeno peppers, tomatoes, garlic, and onion. And I have the tomatoes, and, you know, just the jalapeno peppers, make sure that you cut the stem and seed it.
Okay.
You don't want it seeded, and I just cut it into strips. And what we're going to do, and the garlic cloves, we're going to put it in the oven and broil it for about 5 to 7 minutes.
Okay.
And, you know, anything roasted, you know, it brings out that flavor. And so when we put that into that spaghetti, it just has a more rich flavor. It's
going to
be really good. So we're going to stick that in the oven. And you want that probably about 6 inches from the broiler.
Okay.
And that. So, and our water's boiling, you know, like crazy here for the spaghetti. So we'll turn that down a little bit. But I'm going to go ahead and doing this before, I'm going to broil it. It says 5 to 7 minutes, and I like to go to that pretty much max, because the vegetables are cold.
Okay.
It takes a little bit to get them roasted a little bit.
Okay, sounds good.
So, and got our boiling water. Put a little bit of salt in there, because your pasta always has a better flavor if it's got a little bit of salt in there. You can add salt on it afterwards, but it's not the same as when you cook it in there. So, I got 8 ounces of spaghetti here.
Okay.
So, I'm going to actually go ahead and break that in half so that we don't have it so terribly long. So
I don't know. I was just reading an article not too long ago about what's the proper etiquette to eat spaghetti. Should you cut your spaghetti or should you twirl it? It was about mixed reviews.
Okay, some like either way, huh?
I prefer to cut the spaghetti so it's not all over clothes and slurped all over.
Especially when that red spaghetti sauce, it's really, you know, it stains. And if
it
you
does.
Don't get that off right away, you're going to be in trouble there. So we're going to get this here just to boiling. And This, we're going to actually, after all these ingredients are put together, we're going to put it in a skillet.
Okay.
And bake it for about 25 minutes.
Okay.
So, and, you know, I do have a stainless steel skillet that goes in the, can go in the oven. But if you don't have a skillet you can put in the oven, put it in a 9 by 13, you know, casserole pan.
Sure.
So you certainly don't need to, don't make this, you know, eliminate this recipe because you don't have a skillet.
Right.
So you just want to, you got to try
it. You're going to try this one. It looks so good.
It does. So, okay, we've got that going. So now what we're going to do, we're just going to kind of multitask in here.
Okay.
You know, there was a lot of ingredients, but it's not that it takes so long,
okay,
you know, to do it. So we're going to start with our white sauce, and I'm going to put in 2 tablespoons of butter.
Okay.
And we're going to get that melted, and then we're going to add 2 tablespoons of flour and just kind of brown that maybe for a few seconds.
Okay.
And then add our, you know, milk and cheese, and we've got cumin and cayenne pepper.
It's going to be a little spicy.
It's going to have a little bit of a kick to it, you know. And with the jalapeno peppers too, you know, depends upon when I purchase them. Peppers, they have really big ones and they have smaller ones and stuff. So
sometimes the smaller ones have a bigger kick, don't they?
Sometimes they do in that. So you got to kind of watch. But the biggest thing is your heat, I think, is in the seeds.
Okay.
You know, so when you're seeding that, you know, that really helps to not have it quite so hot.
Okay.
So this is just about melted here. Get that up. And so, like I said, it's 2 tablespoons of flour. So we're going to just mix that up. And the recipe says to kind of just brown that a little bit.
Okay.
And you have that in there. And it doesn't take, you know, too much for that to melt in there. And definitely you want to put your flour in with the butter and not with the flour. So you don't want it lumpy,
right,
and stuff. So that makes a difference. And that, so, and you know, after that, and I already pre-cooked our chicken.
Okay.
I just put it in my skillet and put the lid on it. I put a little bit of seasoning on this chicken. It doesn't necessarily ask for that, but again, when I'm baking things or cooking, I always feel that you get more of a flavor when you cook with the seasoning than just adding it
at the end,
okay, and stuff. So this is starting to bubble here already. So that's going to brown here really quickly. And that's just, you know, when you brown butter, it just gives it a little bit of different flavor.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what their goal is, just to give that a little bit of a, just a little bit more zip to it. Or I shouldn't say zip because it's not hot, but more flavor.
Right.
Robust flavor to that. And it asks for 2 cups of whole milk. And like I usually, in my refrigerator, it's 2%, which is fine.
Mm-hmm.
But you can actually go ahead if you have, you know, a skim 1% or 2%, whatever. And if you have a little bit of cream, add a little bit of cream.
Okay.
You know, just to make that. So we can see that has started to brown now. I'm going to add my milk. And I'm going to turn this down because we want that just to maybe simmer about 3 minutes.
Okay.
Just to kind of get that thickening there.
Sure.
I see we have like 2 minutes left on our vegetables in the oven. And I'm going to just take a quick peek just to make sure everything is looking good here and not too much. Nope, they're not getting too brown. So I think we're going to just leave that. And then we're going to, when we take out the vegetables, we're going to want them cool just a little bit.
Okay.
And then cut them a little into smaller pieces. And, you know, then we're going to add it into our sauce and stuff.
Okay.
So, you can get so many things going at once, it won't take you that long to put this dish together.
As long as you can multitask.
Yes. And of course, we know we women can do that. And most, we have to give credit to men too. They should be able to. They can do it.
Anybody can multitask.
Absolutely. Depends upon what you're doing.
If it comes, sorry to all those men out there.
Yeah.
They're paying attention right now.
But I'll be the first one to be honest. If it comes to computer and all these electronics, I can't multitask. I am to ground zero with that. So I guess we all have our stronger points, right? So
let's. It doesn't matter if you're male or female.
That's right. Yeah. Okay. Well, we have some wonderful male cooks out there. We know that. So I'm going to just check that and see. It's almost. It's just about done. We're going to leave that just another second. Take out our vegetables.
Okay.
Okay.
Yep. So, they're roasting.
There, so we're going to just set that over here. And what I'm going to do is, when I put that skillet in the oven, I want my rack down a little bit lower.
Okay.
And I'm going to take it off of broil and just put it on bake. And at 350 degrees, so we're going to just turn that down a little bit. So.
Okay.
All right, let's just, and you know, with your sauce too, it says to start with 2 cups of milk. You may find that you might add, need a little bit more.
Okay.
And it's not going to be any problems to add a little bit of more milk if you need to when you're, you know, baking it and if you'd like to have it a little bit more creamy. Okay, so we're going to drain these.
Okay.
And I'll just.
You can always get a facial when making spaghetti.
Oh, right. Sauna there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just take this and I'm going to put the spaghetti in our skillet here. So now what we're going to do is I'm going to slowly add our cheese.
And this again was 4 cups of cheese total. So this is a lot of cheese in here.
There is. So it's 2 cups of cheddar and your 2 cups of Monterey cheese.
Okay.
So I'm going to turn the burner off because I don't think we really need that on anymore. I'll just add a little bit to it. And, you know, I've got the finely grated cheese and that really melts quickly, you know, if you have a little bit finer cheese.
Okay.
In your cuts. So as you can see, it's going to definitely be really a nice sauce, you know, with all that cheese and stuff, and you put your other roasted vegetables in there. It actually makes a really pretty dish, too, because, you know, you
all
have
that color.
Your, all that, yes, color with the pepper and all of that, so. So that does not take long to.
Now you don't need to boil that milk like you were saying. You just need to warm it up and
let's get that going here. See, that's already that's how quickly your cheese will melt for you. So we're going to go ahead and put in our other ingredients. It says a half teaspoon of there is my half of cumin.
Okay.
I'm going to take this off here so I can put my spoon in there, my measuring spoon. This one I, a little bit more using my measuring spoon than just, you know, eyeing it. Sometimes some things I like to make sure I have about the right. You can overdo that. And this is a fourth, it's your red pepper, your cayenne pepper.
Okay.
It's only a fourth teaspoon here. So.
Well, you put a little bit of that, you know, it just depends on if you want that a little bit more extra mm-hmm. kick.
That's right. So let's stir that. Okay, and then now we need 2 teaspoons of lemon juice.
Okay.
Or no, it's not lemon, it's lime juice.
Lime.
And that. And you know, if you have fresh lime, great, use that, but I don't think if you don't and you just have the bottle, your lime is going to be in the bottle, it's going to be just fine. Okay, and then I'm going to go ahead and add the half cup chopped fresh cilantro.
Okay.
Get that mixed well. And then, you know, we can add our chicken to this too, just to...
Okay.
I did make my chicken prior and had it in the fridge. It's cold, and this will just heat that up nicely here. I'll just get that to the side there. And
Seasoned the chicken with just a little bit of salt and pepper, you said?
Yes. That's all I did, was a little bit on there. Not a lot, but just adds, I think, like I said, when you're cooking it, gives it a better flavor. So we just get that mixed up. So you can see we've got a nice amount of sauce here. And with your chicken in, and they said about 4 cups of chicken.
Okay. All right.
Okay, so that's done there. What we're going to come over here. And I'm going to just go ahead and put, if you line your pan with foil, you can easily just take it out like this and just, cut it here. Because we want to cut up our onion a little bit here.
Sure. Yeah, those jalapenos as well.
Yes. Yeah, we don't want them quite that big.
You'd have a little bit of a shocking bite if you ate a whole one of those.
Isn't that the truth? Yeah, with that foil, then it's going to be just easy to add it, pick that all up and put it in your sauce. You have less, of a mess or wiping up to do. And I might just go ahead. Although the tomatoes are pretty soft, and I think when we just stir that in, it's going to go ahead and...
They'll break up a little bit.
They'll break up.
Yeah.
That's correct. So... Don't those roasted vegetables smell good, though?
They do.
Okay, so we're going to just go ahead and bring our sauce over here. And now I'm going to just add that there. Okay.
So, I mean, you don't have to stick with just plain old spaghetti. You can certainly spice it up and have a wonderful dish, and
it's just nice.
Family will enjoy this.
Give it a new twist, because pasta always goes over pretty well for most people. They like their pasta, and instead of your traditional spaghetti, and when you're making regular spaghetti, you're adding a little bit of your hamburger probably for your meat, your protein,
sure.
And now we add a chicken. So
great.
That was really great. So we'll get our spaghetti here. And get a spatula, and let's just mix this right here. And we're going to add that.
So this actually, it makes a very nice sized portion here.
A serving of for 8 people,
okay.
Easily, 6 to 8 people.
It doesn't look like there was that many noodles in there. Yeah. But once you add that sauce on there,
it's going to be and it says 8 ounces of spaghetti, and so if you end up with a little bit more, that's just fine. I think the difference, if you have more spaghetti, you probably might end up using a little bit of more milk,
right?
With that,
so it doesn't dry out almost,
right? So you can just see that, but doesn't that look great?
It does. Some very nice color there.
Mm-hmm. Just mix that up a little bit. And with mixing the chicken and all in the cheese sauce, you get it blended well, so it doesn't take too much just to put that in on top of your spaghetti and not have to worry too much about not getting it mixed well.
Sure.
And I did use some spray and sprayed my skillet just a little bit on there. So, but right now, you really see the pasta in there. There's looks like there's going to be plenty.
There does.
So we'll put that in the oven. And we've got that at 350. And we're going to bake that. And we'll turn the timer on for 25 minutes.
Okay.
You know, with that being everything's already pre-cooked in that, it doesn't take a long time, you know, to bake that and put that together. So now for the dessert.
Always good on dessert.
Yeah. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with the 1 1/4. It's 3/4 cup butter.
Okay.
So it's like 1.5 sticks. And I did take that out just to, you know, soften that a little bit. And then my jar of peanut butter. I took out 3/4 cup peanut butter because we're going to be melting some of the chocolate chips and peanut butter together.
Okay.
We're going to add some in here, but we'll also that. And you know, if you have a jar, it says 16 ounces here, and that's 2 cups. So you don't really have to worry
about. Take half the jar.
That's right. Pre-measure there. So
some of the best desserts have peanut butter in them. Oh. I feel bad for the people that are allergic.
Oh, yes. We don't know how fortunate we are when we can eat whatever we want. May not always be the best, but
right.
You know, we have that option. So, okay. So we're going to go ahead and just beat the peanut butter and the butter until it's creamy. And then we're going to beat in a cup of the powdered sugar.
Okay.
And stuff. So let's get that going first. Okay. We've got the butter and peanut butter creamed together very nicely.
Okay.
So we're going to just gradually add a cup of the powdered sugar.
Okay.
I'm going to just put that in there and not. So when I started out with 2 cups of powdered sugar, I just divided that and because we're going to beat this in here. Just till it's mixed well.
Sure.
And then we'll just go ahead and add our graham crackers and a couple of the morsels of chocolate chips. And then we're going to want to get the chocolate chips and the 3/4 cup peanut butter. We're going to want to get that into the microwave. You know, the recipe had said, you know, to put it in a heavy skillet and make sure you stir it well. But it works so well in the microwave, and you pretty much don't have to worry about scorching.
Okay.
You know that. So what I did was I took out a half cup of the chocolate chips.
Okay.
And so the other 1.5 cups I have in here. And now I'm going to put that 3/4 cup of peanut butter in here.
And the recipe actually did call for the mini chocolate chips. But I know that you prefer to bake with the mini chocolate chips instead of the normal sized ones.
You know, I've gotten used to them and I really do like them. I mean, even when you're making chocolate chip cookies, you know, you just get more all in that cookie instead of some big morsels, you have the mini ones. So, okay. So, you know, because that's not going to take very long. I want to get this out of here and then we'll add that. I'm just going to put this over here. So the graham crackers and that and the rest of the powdered sugar, we're going to just mix. You can mix it with a spoon or with graham crackers. You know, in fact, the recipe, you know, says mix with a spoon or with your hands. And to me, nothing mixes better than your hands. So
right.
We're going to do that. Let's put that in the microwave and let's start it for about 2 minutes.
Okay.
And then we'll, when that's done, we'll stir that up. So, okay, now I have 3 cups of crushed graham cracker crust, so we're going to put that in there. And we're also going to work in the other cup of powdered sugar.
And we'll do that chocolate chips at the end.
Right, correct. We'll just get this mixed up a little bit more and then add that and stuff. So just go ahead and get that mixed. And we're going to use a 9x13 pan.
Okay.
And I would have you spray that a little bit. So in order to really get that graham cracker crust really mixed well with the peanut butter and that takes a little bit of...
You probably get more tired using a spoon than you would just using your hands.
Yes, definitely. And then, you know, you can just flip that over, work it a lot better with your hands than with your spoon. So, okay, well, we'll just keep that there. We got just a few more minutes for the 2 minutes in the microwave for that. So I'm going to add this half cup of chocolate chips.
Okay.
And work the rest of that in there. And this is something easy, you know, for even the kids to make. You know, a lot of times kids like to bake or do something, but we're always a little bit more hesitant when it comes to using the oven and heat. And this way, they can make a great bar without you having to be concerned with them burning themselves.
All right.
Okay, how does that? Just take the spatula and just mix that well.
I don't know that we're going to need very much more.
Yeah, those chips. Okay, that looks like when you mix that. Then we pour that over, and so of course, you know, because that's warm, your chocolate chips and that, you're going to need to put that in the refrigerator. And, about an hour is about what you may want before you cut it.
Okay.
And that.
All right, you don't need that. 2 minutes was just the perfect timing for that.
So then, see, as you put your crust in here, you know, you're going to need to be working that with your hands anyway, so that just makes sense to start with your hands, right?
Right.
Okay, and I'm just going to rinse them off, my hands off.
It almost kind of seems a little bit like a scotcheroo bar. Kind of.
Kind of. That's right, yeah. Okay, so, and like I said, when you're melting your chocolate chips and peanut butter, make sure you have a, you know, microwavable bowl.
Right.
And that, so we're going to just pour that over. And then spread that out, and we'll put that in the fridge. And until our spaghetti is done, you know, at least we can kind of just feature it that this, you know, sets up a little bit here.
Right.
Okay. So just take your spatula then and spread that out.
I don't know that there's too many aromas that are better than peanut butter and chocolate.
Does smell good. And such an easy crust, you know, with that graham crackers there and stuff too. So, okay. So we're gonna just put that in the fridge and get that set up, and then we have about 15 minutes left on our spaghetti.
Okay.
And we'll be able to come back and finish up here.
Sounds great.
Well, let's look at our chicken spaghetti here. Our buzzer is going off, so we will see how that looks, and that was at 25 minutes there. Okay. Oh, that looks great. So we're gonna
looks great, smells great.
Bring that over here, and we can just put that here. And we'll just, you know, probably while this cooling a little bit, and I'm gonna leave this mitt on here just to remind you. Remind me that it's hot.
Yes.
And that. Let's get our no-bake peanut butter chocolate bars out. And I know that it's not set up quite like what we'd like it to, because it's not quite an hour.
Okay.
But we can cheat a little bit and just show that.
When it comes to dessert, that's all it is.
It is, isn't it? That's a good way to... There. Oh, see? Well, wrong plate. Chocolate's good. Okay. So, be nice to probably cut more than one piece, but being it's not.
We'll let the rest set up.
That's right, yeah. So, I'm going to just take this out here and.
Oh, it smells just wonderful.
And you know that sauce is about just perfect here, you know. It's nice and creamy. There's plenty of sauce, but not skimping. So let's just put a little ground pepper on that and a little bit of kosher salt. Not a lot. And, of course, we can always just really decorate that with a little bit of cilantro. So.
All right.
Well, I don't know if I should let you hold that, but...
I suppose you can trust me.
I can trust you. Huh? Okay. Yeah,
uh-huh. Well, these are awesome recipes. I think anybody that tries these, you're just going to be satisfied with these recipes. They weren't hard to make, and they smell wonderful. I know they're even going to taste better than they even look. So.
No. Is that possible?
I think so.
Okay.
To get these recipes, just go to Consolidated's website, www.ctctel.com. Please submit your recipes for us to cook for you on the show. Thank you always to the workshop for being our sponsor, and join us on Cooking.